Hey, what's going on, guys? Just an update for the Demamp Camp series. I've been pretty busy playing Metal Gear Solid 5, new Fallout 4 coming out, Frag for Cancer.
I know the truth!
What the fuck, dude? About what?
Milli Vanilli.
Oh, God.
That miraculously springs in 1988 tragically ends not 2 years after their conception. What went wrong? How did it come to such an abrupt end? Was what we were told the truth? In 1988, West German Munich, two unknown individuals were discovered by Frank Farian, a German music producer. The first known sightings of Milli Vanilli was during the nightly karaoke around the bars around Munich. When Frank Farian approached them for an opportunity to become a musical sensation, he was surprised to see that neither had any official records, let alone personal identification. Through his spy network connections with Stasi, the Ministry for State Security, he was able to forge them an identity, thus going under the pseudonyms Fab Morvan and Rob Pilatus, the great Milli Vanilli was conceived. Their R&B funk was so captivating that they took Germany east and west by storm. Unofficial reports state that Milli Vanilli brokered a unification of East and West, which led to the Berlin Wall coming down and concluding on October 3rd, 1990. Their talent and charisma could only be compared to that of Elvis, Bob Dylan, Paul McCartney, and Mick Jagger. Their fame grew so exponentially that they caught the unfeeling eye of the Illuminati. Masquerading under the company Kraft, they approached the group and offered them a sponsorship for the Kraft peanut butter products, which would have been marketed to South Africa. However, this was a ploy to infiltrate their way inside the workings of Milli Vanilli and ruin them from the inside. Having connections with MTV, they began a smear campaign when their music came overseas to the glorious Central America. Their interviews were edited in post-production and dubbed with inferior voices to sell them as hacks and frauds. Singers coming out from under the thumb of the Illuminati testified that they were the true musicians and that Rob Pilatus and Fab Morvan were merely the image. It wasn't until November 19, 1990 that their image was tarnished. A live performance which appeared to showcase them as lip syncers at the Grammys cost them the public's trust. Little did the public realize that their microphones had been turned off and that the looped track mix-up was planned all along. Unable to tell their side of the story in fear that their family and friends would have been killed, Milli Vanilli decided to keep quiet about their fraud attempts. Having the Grammys revoked for their hit album, Girl You Know It's True, was the beginning of insults that the Illuminati would use to torture Milli Vanilli. Today, they have retroactively eliminated any recordings played in the media, and all songs found on streaming sites have been dubbed with the false voices. Here is the last true recording of Milli Vanilli's voice that is still in circulation. In the aftermath, Morvan and Pilatus tried to release their true voices on an independent album called Rob and Fab. Yet again, the Illuminati stepped in and used their media control to hamper promotion and resulting in poor sales. This led to eventual disbandment of the group, controversy, jail time, and the tragic death of Rob Pilatus, having been found dead in his hotel room in Frankfurt, Germany, from an apparent overdose of prescription drugs. The autopsy was unable to find the high level of sedatives that was forcibly injected into his body, much like how Marilyn Monroe was killed by the CIA years before. Why would the Illuminati prioritize so much effort in eliminating a couple of German music's career? The simple answer is that they believed the world was not prepared for the level of enlightenment that came with their songs. The sheer talent that was displayed in each of their early recordings was enough to go platinum 5 times. In time, they believed they would have been uncontrollable, and the world would not be able to handle the expectations of living up to the Milli Vanilli standards. However, there is a group of us who knows the truth and understands that Milli Vanilli is the next step in human evolution. In public battle royale servers in H1Z1, a couple of goons who know the truth spread the word to the masses under the phrase, Milli Vanilli was an inside job.
Job. Milli Vanilli was an inside job. There are no non-believers here.
Milli Vanilli was an inside job.
Milli Vanilli was indeed an inside job.